Alrighty, welcome to a legacy video here on channelfireball.com, and we're building around Yorion Sky Nomad. I saw this list and I loved it. I immediately cut a spell for a land and moved on. So what this deck is trying to do is first of all, 80 cards, so that you have Yorion as your companion, and then it's got four copies of Arkham's Astrolabe, Icefang Quaddle, a bunch of Planeswalkers, Snapcaster Mages, all of which get you pretty good value when you flicker them with Yorion. Planeswalkers a little less so because you don't get to use them because it comes back on your end step, but it does give you an extra card on the Quaddles and Astrolabes, and if your Planeswalkers have taken some damage, you can reset them to their starting loyalty. It's also got Swords to Plowshares and Terminus as creature interaction, plus of course the Quaddles, Forces, plus Counterspells, Ponders and Brainstorms in order to see enough cards, some main deck Veils, and then an old throwback, Intuition, for three copies of Accumulated Knowledge, so that you get to get some good value there with Snapcasters as well. And one Savine's Reclamation. This is a weirdo. It's three mana, return a permanent with converted mana cost, three or less from your graveyard. But if you flash it back and it's a 5-mana flashback, you can get double value. So you can Intuition for like Savine's Reclamation and like two Planeswalkers and get some decent value. Plus Caracas is sweet with Yorion and with Uro. Sideboard's got red, because why not add the fourth color, for two copies of From the Ashes, which destroys all non-basic land. And then Red Blasts and Pyroblasts. So some sweet stuff going on here. Let's see how this goes. Alrighty, time for round one. I'm going to reveal my companion here and get to it. This deck's a little slow for Legacy. Oh, I'm going to keep this hand. I didn't come here to mulligan this, but I'm not feeling great about any sort of fast matchup with this hand, though. My opponent played a Flooded Strand, which could mean a lot of things, but, you know, at the very least, means they're not playing like a turn one Delver or anything like that. This is a special area for a companion waiting to be cast with a little heart. I love it. And my turn two play, probably crack a Flooded Strand and start casting an Accumulated Knowledge. Ooh, a Ponder. That's kind of interesting. Let's go Trop and let's just play Ponder here. Oh, I like this. All right. I will not shuffle and I'm probably not even going to crack the Flooded Strand in turn because I wouldn't mind drawing me a Brainstorm here. And then I get to turn three, play a Planeswalker with Force Backup. Astrolabe, sure. And are we playing against like Snow Miracles of some kind? Like, is this a counterbalance coming out here? Yeah, it is. I think I'm going to let that resolve, and I'll still draw my Brainstorm here, though I know that one could be a little riskier. And then, since I'm not playing against Wasteland, I'm going to get Tundra and Trop here. And I'll play the Teferino Time Raveler and hope to not get counterbalanced. If I get counterbalanced here, it's going to be brutal. Let's see. Oh, they're just going to force in response? Yeah, I guess I'll force back. I'll pitch Accumulated Knowledge here. And now they reveal the Force of Will off counterbalance. that is a way to lose, that's for sure. And then they have a back to basics, right? That card. Okay. Well, I guess that kind of does it, doesn't it? yeah. Well, I'm going to put in some Pyroblasts and Red Blasts, and I'm going to put in Wilt. I'm going to put in Flusterstorm. I'm going to take out some Swords. I know they could have Monastery Mentors. Take out Terminus. I guess at that point I would rather leave a Swords in. Don't want Surgicals. Yeah, this seems fine. I guess I could just put in Supreme Verdict. That actually might be better than having Swords. I don't know what else I want to take out. Maybe I just want the one Supreme Verdict in. Yeah. All right, I would in fact like to play first here. Yeah, reveal Yurian as my companion. Yeah, I'll keep this hand. And I drew double AK here, so what I'm going to do probably is I'm just going to play Mystic Sanctuary and then play turn two Accumulated Knowledge. Well, turn two I'm going to leave up Counterspell and then cast Accumulated Knowledge if they don't play anything. That is my plan. And I think it's safest just to play the Sanctuary on turn one just because it's just a little risky. If I don't play it on turn one, then I have to play it later in a bad spot. I don't like that. Well, I don't care about countering a second Astrolabe here. Or a third one, for that matter. All right. Let's go ahead and cast Accumulate Knowledge. I wish this card didn't exist. I think Arkham's Astrolabe has been a substantial negative to Magic. I am playing it in this deck, but that doesn't change how I feel about it. Let's just go Ponder and then leave up Counterspell slash AK. Ooh, a third AK. I like that. I like that a lot. All right, no. And I'm going to have to shuffle them away, so play the Prismatic Vista. But there's a chance that I might just use Counterspell here. Okay, they didn't do anything, so now I'm going to run out end of turn AK. And these get sequentially more powerful. Let's just get a snow-covered island here. And I guess I could have gotten a snow-covered forest. I wouldn't be surprised if they like red blasted me or something. No, they did not. What am I going to do? I guess back to basics is just going to get me pretty good here. Because I don't want to play the Astrolabe because I want to leave up Quaddle plus AK or Counterspell. I also don't care if they cast Brainstorm there. Like, yeah, their hand's full. This is probably pretty good, but I don't think fighting over card selection is going to be where I want to be. There's also a good chance here that I want to crack Flooded Strip for just a basic Plains or a basic Island just because of Back to Basics. Something I got to keep in mind. Let's just go AK, and I actually, yeah, they just let me have it. Yeah, you know what? I'm just going to have to deal with Back to Basics if that happens, because I want to get the Ice Fang Quaddle in play. If they didn't counter my Ancestral, I would be surprised if they countered this. And play a land. Let's just get another island here. And actually, you know what? I'm going to play Euro first. And I'm not going to fight over Euro, I don't think. Okay, this works for me. Game three, I put a Flooded Strand into play. And then now, in order to not discard, I can actually... Oh, wait, playing an Astrolabe still leads me to discard. Let's just hit my opponent here. And I'm going to keep my mana up. The question is, what do I want to discard here? And it might actually be the Astrolabe. I think at that point, I guess I might as well just cast it. And yeah, now I can just discard an island, I think. Snapcaster, Brainstorm, sure. Don't care too much about that. Plus, the subsequent Brainstorm is worth less, just because presumably they already put back some of their dead cards. Yeah, I guess it would be nice to have drawn Misties at some point. Maybe I should have used Prismatic Vista to get a forest. I didn't really anticipate running into this situation. Not that it's a big deal, but let's see what they've got. All right, they got their Plains. And so I'm going to Counterspell, Force Pitching Brainstorm, Force Pitching like Oko. Because Snapcaster right now draws me three cards off Accumulated Knowledge. I have a little mini Ancestral hiding in my graveyard here. I can also crack Strand to get Mystic Sanctuary. End of turn here. Ponder's fine. Let's see what their plan is. I mean, presumably they're going to do something at some point, right? You would think. But I guess that's yet to be determined. All right, here we go. Oh, yeah, here we go. Fourth Astrolabe. Now we're really talking. And now they're going to pass. Yeah. So I've got like two options in a turn. I can brainstorm and I can sanctuary. Let's just kick things off with a brainstorm. And let's put back a Sanquaddle and a land. And end of turn, I'm going to go get Mystic Sanctuary. I'm going to target Accumulated Knowledge here. Draw my AK, play my land, and I think I just pass here. I'll just leave the Quaddle back. And then now I can have just a bunch of counter spells up and a draw three. Yeah, that's fine. You can brainstorm. So one thing I actually don't want to do is trade Quaddle for Snapcaster Mage, but I'm going to leave it back for a turn to see if it can stop them from attacking. If it doesn't, I missed out on a point of damage, but yeah, okay. See, actually, because I have Yorion, so I actually don't really want to trade there. All right, let's cast AK. They have Spell Snare? Or are they going to... Oh, they're just going to use Astrolabe and Pyroblast me that way. I would imagine that is their plan. Oh, they do have Spell Snare. Funny. I'm going to use Pyroblast here, partially because I only have the one Astrolabe, and I might have to tap it on my turn to bring back Uro, so I want to use my Pyroblast while I can. They're really going to let me just draw three cards, just like that? Oh no, here's their Pyroblast. Alright, I'll start casting these things. I also don't care too much if this doesn't work. Because I have a Snapcaster, I have... Like, I'm not going to pitch to Force of Negation to force this through. Does not seem worth it. Okay, they're going to Mystic Sanctuary targeting their Spell Snare. Okay. Are they going to brainstorm in response? Sure. I do not mind them using up a brainstorm in a Mystic Sanctuary, even though it's not card disadvantage or anything. If that's how they want to do it, they're not even going to get an extra shuffle. All right. AK down and draw. Ooh, Caracas is nice. So let's actually play Caracas and play Uro. Yeah, and exile 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just five lands. And now if they have Swords to Plowshares, it does not help. Wouldn't hate drawing a land here. Oh, no lands, all right. And then at this point I will send. And then now I have Force plus Counterspell up and Caracas, and they have to do something about Uro because, I mean, if this attacks, I get to draw another card, and it's a 6-6. Oh, Entreat the Angels. So they really did use their brainstorm effectively. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you're going to Entreat for a bunch. I probably don't want that to happen. What are they Entreating for? Like, I guess they're Entreating for 4. Is that right? Yeah. We're trying to. Well, let's find out. Okay, yeah, they just maybe had the mana wrong. Or they're going to Entreat for less to leave up some sort of counter. Oh no, they're just going to Entreat for 4. Okay, I'm going to counterspell that. And if they have a Force of Will, I'll force back. Okay. And I'm going to exile Oko. I think that's less good, because if they have another Force here, I might have ended up in a spot where I needed to trade Quaddle for I could beat an Entreat for 4. I have double Ice Fang Quaddle and a Uro, which is going to eat one of their Angels to begin with. Okay, let's just draw. I was considering using a Snapcaster on Accumulated Knowledge in order to draw three and then definitely be able to put an extra land into play. But I think leaving up Snapcaster Counterspell is probably going to be better here. I'm just going to hard cast Force of Will, and then they're going to concede. Nice, nice, nice. All right, game 2. I realize I should put this mountain in. kind of a doofus move not to. What do I want to cut? I kind of like everything. How do I have an 80 card deck? And I'm like, oh, how do I make a cut here? I guess I could just take out a land. I wonder if I can take out a Tundra on the against the back to basics deck where I'm on the draw. Seems good. All right, I'll reveal Yorion, which has yet to be cast, but I was getting close last time. I was getting close. Ooh, I kind of like this hand. Could use an Astrolabe. Couldn't they all? I'll play my Flooded Strand. Look, I don't love cracking for non-basics, but I think it might be important to leave up. Like, if they play counterbalance and I force it, I want to have Veil of Summer up just in case. Pass the turn. I'll run out Ice Fang at some point. They have no plays, huh? Oh, they don't even have a land this turn? Well, I'm going to run out Ice Fang Quaddle. And they can counter it if they really want to. I don't have enough green to run this out with Veil Protection. And it's not really that impressive against them, to be honest. I guess I can just play my land. Kind of want to wait on the Misty for Mystic Sanctuary, though. We're a little far away from that. This is the kind of game where I think Yorion is pretty good, because I have a bunch of counter spells. They're not doing much. They have a lot of cheap cards in their deck, so at some point we're going to fight. We're going to trade some cards, and hopefully after all the dust settles, I can slam Yorion and use it to draw an extra card off Quaddle, and that's already a pretty big advantage. They're discarding the hand size. Well, I'm fine just chilling then. What could be in their hand? A bunch of Pyroblasts? I don't know, but I'm feeling pretty good. Now this has Death Touch. Game. So, like, now if they make a play, I get to do something like Hardcast Force of Negation with Veil of Summer backup, and if that fails, I can pitch something to Force a Will. My matchup against Mana Screwed opponents is excellent. Let me just tell you that much. All right. And if they fight over this, it'd be so good for me. I'm not going to Yorion yet. I'm going to wait another turn. Oh, that was actually insane. Let's just do that. Just play Oko. Oko with double one mana counter and a Force of Will up. All right. Let's just make a food token for now. I don't really want to elk up the Ice Fang. I'd rather just have those as separate entities. So a weird thing that comes up in Legacy is Veil of Summer can stop your spells from being countered with Pyroblast. It cannot protect Oko from Pyroblast because it doesn't give Hexproof from red. But it does say your spells can't be countered. So if they like Pyroblast the Oko, I can just, bam, Flusterstorm it. And if they have another counter spell, then I can maybe use it. Do I want to draw Force of Negation? I kind of feel like I do, to be honest. Aether Gusting in response. Cute. I didn't really factor in Aether Gust, to be honest, but it's okay. I will Flusterstorm. Here I could have used Veil, but Flusterstorm obviously is going to be a fine counter as well. Okay, that gets countered. Let's go get Mystic Sanctuary. Let's put back, I think I still put back Force of Negation here. Because I want this to be the thing that I kick any counter war off with. And of course, now that we have Oko, they're the one forced to do something. Because they're getting killed by our Planeswalker plus our... Well, the Quaddle's not really doing much. Mostly Oko. But now I have Force of Negation with Veil of Summer up plus a Force of Will. Not quite to the point where I also have Snapcaster into anything. Probably Force Pitching Force, if I had to guess here. There's also not that much that I care about. Also, if they hardcast like a creature, like a Mentor, I can just force it. All right, I am going to cast Force of Negation here. Okay. Veil of Summer. And that, I think, has a good chance of ending the game. And in fact, it does. Bam. There goes round one. Let's head to round two. All righty, time for round two. Let's reveal Yorion. Get things started. Oof, this hand's bad. I'm gonna keep it, but it's bad. Am I gonna keep it? I think I'm gonna keep it. kind of don't want to keep it, actually. Double Mystic Sand. Yeah, this hand's actually just trash. What am I thinking? All right, yeah, this hand's a lot better, and I can put Savine's Reclamation on the bottom. Wow, a hand that has actual plays in the beginning of the game? Shocker. Oh, playing with Death and Taxes. I'm very glad I have Mulligan then. So now the question is, it's actually kind of tricky. I need an Astrolabe. Because they have Wasteland, so I think I'm just going to get a Snow-Covered Island and cast Ponder here. And, oof, I don't like that. All right, Trop is fine. I just wanted to be protected from Wasteland for my first couple lands. This actually works out fine because now I get to use Strand to get a Plains, which is why I kept that one, so I can cast these Swords to Plowshares. Let's see, another Vial. Vial's kind of annoying. I would call it Vial. Oh, that's kind of nice. So let's just do that. And then that way I can potentially play Quaddle, potentially play Swords. It kind of depends. I have the feeling they're going to Thalia me because they have Caracas. Caracas Thalia is a really strong combo with a Vial where basically their Thalia is just sitting there protected. But I actually have a decent amount of lands, and if they don't have Rashad in port, I might be in a position to just cast my spells past Thalia and just kind of ignore her. It's annoying that even the Quaddle can't kill Thalia, but what can you do? No plays, huh? Are they going to Vial and Thalia in response? No. Okay, let's get Forest. I mean, they haven't played Wasteland, but I still would rather, especially since I have a 5-drop I want to play, that doesn't get affected by Thalia, luckily. I would rather wait on putting my non-basics into play until essentially last. Oh, Astrolabe. Yeah, it's very nice. We have a couple options here. You know what? I'm just going to get the Oko into play. I don't know what they've got coming here. Let's get Snow-Covered Plains. But I've got a Defender, and Oko's a pretty strong card. Make a food token. Now, even if they put a creature into play, they probably can't attack my Oko. And I'll leave the Quaddle back, which also has Death Touch because I've gotten 3 basics so far. We got plans. Yes, we do. So what, are they going to put like a Stoneforge Mystic into play? Going to Swords my Quaddle? Sure. I mean, I guess they could put a Revoker, but they could have put that into response to Oko. All right, so they are going to get a Stoneforge Mystic. I don't, like, care too much about that. Also, depending on which, like, if they get a Batterskull, I can just Oko the Batterskull at some point. All right, that's fine. And I've got double Swords to Plowshares here, so feeling decent about all this. So they're going to move up to 3-2. I mean, Vial's really, really strong. I would love to have a way to deal with that. Technically, I can start using Oko on their Vials. I don't know that I'm in a position to necessarily want to do that, but you know what? That doesn't sound outrageous. Karak is funny. Let's just play Astrolabe first. Draw a card. That doesn't really do much. Now what? I can Oko and make a food into an elk. I can Oko their Vial. You know what? I think, man, I'm worried about Flicker Wisp is what I'm really worried about. Flicker Wisp is like kind of annoying no matter how you slice it. They have 4 cards in hand. I have 1 Swords, effectively 2 Swords up. I can Swords the Batterskull. That's fine. I could also just trading. Flicker Wisp is just such a messed up card. You know, they have 2 Vials. Let's just make my food into a 3-3 and go from there. Play my Trop, expose it to Wasteland, and pass the turn. I think that's the best I can do here. And then just pass and hope they don't have anything too good to Vial in, though. I'm sure they will. They missed a land drop. Okay, I can live with that. They did it during my main phase, weirdly enough. Interesting, they didn't Vial in anything. Huh. That's kind of weird. Do they have like a Palace Jailer in hand or something? I guess I don't get it. Okay, that vial didn't go up, and that vial didn't go up, so I guess not. They missed a land drop, remember? This is turn 5, they have 3 land in play. They could have another swords in their hand, I guess. I kind of think I just swords the gem here. I don't know, like what... I mean, I don't care too much if the Oko gets hit, but I guess there's just no reason to let it get hit. If they want to eventually return Batterskull, that's fine to me too. And let's see. And then they pass. I feel like they have a Swords to Plowshares in hand. It would be really hard for me to imagine they didn't have a second one. Especially given they didn't vial anything in a playoff, a 3 and a 2, and didn't play a land. There's not that much more they can have. Good Swords of the Stoneforge Mystic, but I don't know that that's super productive. All right, let's play Euro. And they just don't have Wayfinder right now, so I'm going to leave those up. I guess I could have tap drop. I don't know. So let's draw Accumulated Knowledge, put nothing into play, and let's just Caracas the Uro. I think that's fine. I'm just worried. I mean, I guess they didn't have a Swords. They could have Swordsed it. Huh. Weird. All right, and then... let's just make another food token, and I guess pass the turn? And if they return Batterskull, I guess I'll Swords the Stoneforge. I don't really know what's going on or what's in their hand. So now, oh, they're going to Stoneforge again. Okay, I guess that's fine. Put a Sword of Fire Ace in, sure. Okay, Vial for 3 resolves. It says Sanctum Prelate, and they're going to name one Luris of the Dream Den. Sure, that doesn't really do anything right now. Okay, they're going to 2 cards. I'm not feeling so bad about this. Like, Aether Vial is a messed up card, like I said. It's really crimping the options I have, but yeah, I don't care too much. Sure, I mean... they have a Caracas, so I guess they can bounce Luris if I do anything to it. But I also have a Caracas, so I can also bounce Luris. And then I'm just going to chump with my food token. And that doesn't really bother me too much. Oh, they're going to attack Oko, and they're not even going to trigger their sword. Sure. I think that's fine. I don't know. Oko's tough. Oko can rumble. It can take a big sword hit. If they'd attacked me, I certainly would have done something. But if they're attacking Oko directly, then I'll trade some loyalty for a food. It's like, would you pay 5 loyalty to put a 3-3 into play? Probably, given the position I'm in with Oko right now. Okay, let's play Uro again. But this time I'm not going to bounce Uro with Caracas. I'm going to keep that for Luris. Another land? No more lands. All right. And then I'm going to pass. Oh, I should probably make a token. Here, let's go ahead and make this into a token. And I guess I'm still worried about Flicker Wisp here, but I feel like I'm doing all right. Like, they're not really accomplishing much. I mean, there's a lot of cards they could draw that would be effective, but if I just sit here, I'm the one who's drawing extra cards and getting a Planeswalker activation every turn. Like, their last couple turns, they didn't really do anything. Yeah, they're just not using these vials. I guess drawing 2 vials does have a cost. Oh, you know what they could have in their hand? They could also easily have a second copy of Caracas. They usually play, like, 3 Caracas, and obviously, it's a powerful card, worth playing a lot of, but it is legendary. So, again, when your opponent's not doing things, you get a lot of information as to what they could possibly have in their hand. And for sure, here, I'm thinking that it's more copies of Caracas and maybe Swords to Plowshares. They're casting a card with Aetherphile in play. Oh, they're moving sword. Okay. Oh, are they going to attack with the Stoneforge Mystic? So they can attack with Stoneforge Mystic. Oh, and Luris. What am I doing here? They're both attacking Oko, right? Mm-hmm. And they could have a second copy of Luris in hand, I guess. Let's just block there. And if they Caracas Luris, then that's just really not something I care about. I could Swords the Stoneforge at this point. It seems kind of clear they don't have a Flicker Wisp. I would be surprised if they didn't Flicker Wisp at some point. They're going to Caracas their Luris. Do I want to Swords that? I kind of don't. Let's just Swords their Stoneforge. And look, if they have Flicker Wisp now, then they can go get another equipment. At least their Vial's tapped and they have Flicker Wisp. Oh, they're going to Vial for two? What are they Vialing for two for? Kind of confused. I mean, I would be not surprised. Oh, Charming Prince. So they had the two mana Flicker Wisp. Sure. All right, they can go get another equipment. And then this goes back. And nothing happens. End of turn, I get to cast an AK. Oh, yeah. I guess I might as well see what they get with Stoneforge. What's their third equipment? Do they have a Jita in the main deck as well? Maybe a Sword of Feast and Famine? I think it's just those two and Jita, but... Again, I'm kind of dipping my toe back into Legacy with me and my 80-card deck here, so... there is that. My opponent's taking their time here. So they've been waiting on the Charming Prince, huh? Sure. Okay. Stoneforge it up. What you got? Nothing. Okay. Well, in that case, I'll cast AK for one. Draw, a Force of Will, whatever. Is it time to cast Yorion? Might be. I could Nug. You know what? I kind of want to Nug their Aetherphile. Yeah, that seems actually pretty good. Like, I don't care if they have a 3-3 here. Okay, now if they have a Flicker Wisp or something, I kind of want to know about it. Oh, yeah. I guess I knew about Luris. And then now, I could play Euro, but they could just do that. I think I just play Yorion. And I'm going to flicker just the Astrolabe, I think. And then play my land. And then I already used Oko. Pass the turn with a bunch of blockers here. I could Caracas their Luris, but I don't really need to do that. Ooh, don't hate Jace. I guess my long-term plan here is to Oko their other Vial and just make it so they have to play all their spells on their main phase. Do they have attacks here? I've got two Chumpers no matter what, and they're green, so the sword doesn't get around them. I mean, they can bounce my Yorion, but I'm fine with that. I can bounce their Luris. Take that. And then I have some forces and crap in my hand that I just haven't been able to cast for a long time. And that's all completely well and good. So, yeah, if they sword something up, they can't block with Yorion because it's blue, but I can still just double block with the Elks here. I guess I have to worry that if I trade off for any of the small things, they get to Luris them back, but... I have a Caracas, so I can bounce their Luris at that point. Okay. Yeah. Sword of Fire Ace it up. Go nuts. Also, since I have a counterspell, what I think I'm going to do is double block the Charming Prince here, and then Caracas the Lurrus, probably end of combat, just so they don't know it's happening until after combat resolves. Oh, good. They're attacking with Vile, too. I like that. Because, oh, and Lurrus? Yeah, that's fine. Are they going to bounce my Urien before blockers? If they don't do that, then I get to block their Vile for free. Also, I'm not that worried about Swords to Plowshares because I have my I have a bunch of pitch counters that weren't doing a whole lot here. Okay, so I think they probably wanted to bounce first, but this works. Because I think they're hoping to kill their Vial and recast it from the graveyard, but and that will not be happening on my watch. All right, now they're bouncing Urien, which they should have certainly done earlier. I'm going to bounce Lurrus here so Oko takes less damage. Caracas is kind of a dumb card. Also, Caracas was printed in Legends where all these cool Legends were, and it just dunks on all of them. It's just kind of ridiculous, to be honest. Okay, and then I traded a food for a Charming Prince. Plus, they invested mana in equipping the sword, and they're not on tons of mana right now. I could also... I guess I don't need an end of combat stop anymore. I can also crack Scalding Tarn to go get Mystic Sanctuary. I actually have exactly four islands if I want to get back a Swords to Plowshares. I don't even think I do, to be honest. I think I'm fine. They're going to Vial for two. What do they have? A Revoker. Oh, well, never mind. I will probably be getting back a Swords to Plowshares then, shan't I? All right. Mm-hmm. Mystic Sanctuary, get back swords. Yes. Draw. Swords your Revoker. Make your Aether Vial into another creature. And I don't think I actually want a Urien here. I'm pretty sure I'm going to Jace. And I could bounce one of the tokens, or one of the vials, rather. I mean, I know they get the vial back, but that's fine. Yeah, that seems pretty good to me. And I guess it, I don't know if it matters which one is which. And now, I guess they can kill Jace. Oh, I guess the downside of this, they could equip and attack Jace to death here. They equip Stoneforge with... Yeah, maybe I needed to not... I mean, I'm really far ahead, but that's not really an excuse. But yeah, maybe instead of making an Aether Vial into a creature this turn, I should have just made my Astrolabe into a creature, because now I'm actually going to end up losing Jace here. They actually should attack me with the Stoneforge and Jace with the Aether Vial. That'll work out better for them. I mean, I think I'm in pretty good shape regardless, but yes, that is slightly better. Oh, they're attacking Jace with both. Okay, well, in that case, take the opportunity to trade vials here. Jace dies. I mean, this did also use their whole turn, so again, I don't feel too bad about it. And I get to end of turn cast AK for two here. Oh, they're going to cast a vial. I actually think I'm going to counterspell the vial. One of the few cards counters good against here. I knew they had a second Caracas. I knew it. Another vial? Sure. Yeah, sure. They can have a little vial. I mean, I could exchange control of these. I have a bunch of things. I guess the Stoneforge is kind of annoying. I wonder if I should just kick things off with an AK, draw two, and just see what's up. Oh, there's a Mystic Sanctuary. You know what? Actually, I think I'm going to two. Maybe I should have Mystic Sanctuary first, but I'm going to make sure Mystic Sanctuary of Swords to Plowshares. Say yes. play Yorion to flicker the Astrolabe, and then on my end of turn, I'm gonna swords the swords the Stoneforge Mystic. So let's go to my end of turn. This comes out. I draw a card. And just swords that now. All right. And then now they're in a position where they can Caracas my Yorion, but that's fine with me. I can keep replaying it to bounce Astrolabe. And I have an Oko going, so it's going to be hard for them to make headway. At some point, I might Oko their other Vial just to constrain them even more. But again, not really too worried. What do they have? Flicker Wisp. Flicker their Batterskull. So now they're going to get back a Germ. You know what's good against Batterskull? Oko Thief of Crowns. You know what? Oko Thief of Crowns is just an amazing card. Ooh, I see Quaddle. I kind of like that. Let's go Quaddle. I guess I have six when I had a Force Wall. That was kind of weird. Why did I do that? The Batterskull is going to lose all abilities. Oko is just an absurd magic card, to be honest. And then I'm going to hit with Yorion. And I guess they might get to hit me with Flicker Wisp here. Yeah, that's fine. I can survive a Flicker Wisp hit. Play Yorion. And then exile the Quaddle and the Astrolabe. And then I'll play my land. And it'd be nice if I hit a Swords to Plowshares here, but even if I don't, like, I'm not that worried. Actually, I guess I should have nugged. I was so excited to nug the Batterskull. I guess I should have nugged the sword. Fire and Ice. It's fine, though. Like, they get to equip Flicker Wisp, and they can hit me for 5, and they can draw a card. I still have Force of Will here. I guess I'm tapped out of Caracas, so if they have swords for Yorion now, I'll just Force of Negation that, probably. This deck, it's got a lot going on. I'll tell you that much. It has a lot going on. Also, for what it's worth, there's almost no chance my opponent can play 3 games at the pace they're playing. I mean, this is game 1. I'm going to win it, I think. It's going to take probably 4 more minutes off their clock or whatever. Recruiter of the Guard. You know what? I'm going to Force a Will that. I got nothing better to do, and there's not that many things I can counter. So, let's just nug that and continue on here. Maybe next turn. I knew they had so many Caracases. I guess they can swords my Yorion now that I'm tapped out. That's pretty good. If they don't have that, though, they're in a heap of trouble. I mean, they still are, even if they do have that, but they're in a special heap. All right, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we're not exiling any accumulated knowledges. All right, I think they're done. I think they've decided that is enough. All right, good call. Sideboard. I guess some Wilts and a Wilt and some Supreme Verdicts. And I don't think I really want Force of Negation. I guess Veil of Summer is even worse. Take out 2 Veils, and maybe I'll just take out Narset. I don't love Force of Negation, but at least... Oh, wait, I should put in Containment Priests. This shuts down Vial pretty nicely. Yeah, and then I'll take out Forces, because Force of Negation, the only thing it counters in their whole deck is Aether Vial, which, granted, is their, like, best card, but I still don't really want to be in a spot where I'm forcing that all that much. All right, I'll reveal Yorion Sky Nomad, because I will continue to play millions of cards. Ooh, I like this hand. First of all, any hand with Astrolabe is insane. Astrolabe is such a stupid card. Like, I'm playing the card. That doesn't mean I think it's a good card to exist. Oh, and they don't have Aether Vial? Well, that's almost just game by itself. But, like, look, I get to play Astrolabe on turn 1. It fixes my mana, so I can not be exposed to Wasteland. And then it just means that Yorion will give me free cards later in the game for just no reason, just because I happen to draw an Arkham's Astrolabe. Phyrexian Revoker, sure. I'm not forcing that. Especially since I have to pitch Oko anyway. They got my Astrolabe. They got it. They heard me talking about how good it was. Let's just play Tundra. The reason is I want to be able to leave up Swords and Counterspell here, and I really don't want to crack Tarn for white if I do end up wanting to cast Swords, because I need to crack Tarn for Trop to cast Oko. I'm going to Counterspell this. Like, I don't care what it is. Unless it's them literally casting Swords to Plowshares on their Phyrexian Revoker. Like, a 3-mana main phase card. Oh, Needle? Sure. Like, Needling Oko is annoying, but whatever. Maybe I should have Counterspelled it. I don't know. I just pitch Oko to Force. It's just not a huge part of my plan here. All right. I'll take the damage. They have effectively a 2-1 no text in play. They're going to upkeep port my Tundra. I'm going to live with that. Mm-hmm. Ooh, Snapcaster Mage is not bad. I get some multiple. Basically, how this game I think is going to go, especially without a Vial, is I'm just going to Counterspell and Swords to Plowshares all of their threats. And at some point, maybe I'll get a Thalia. Well, that's just definitely not okay. And at some point, maybe I'll get Oko out and deal with that Needle in some form or fashion, but I'm not stressing about it. And they're going to port me again. Oh, they didn't port me. That's fine, though. I think I just play the Island here, because I don't really want a Mystic Sanctuary back Counterspell. And I do really want to wait on Tarn until I hit... Wow, they didn't port me at all. Weird. Until I need green mana for it. Porting my Tundra would have actually been pretty good. I might have Swords their Revoker in response. Now I can Snapcaster Mage Counterspell, which is huge. And then next turn... Wow, is there a world where I can go like Snap, Counterspell, and then Sword something, and then Snap, and then Yorion, the Snapcaster, and the Astrolabe? That sounds kind of insane. Yeah, I mean, countering the Needle is the only interesting decision I've had so far, and if I'm not sure about it. I might have been wrong. I might, because I knew they were going to name Oko. But now I have Oko to pitch to Force, and I don't know. It feels like things are going fine. I think I might, if they port my Tundra, I think I'm just going to Swords here. Yeah. And then this sets up Snap Swords at some point as well. Oh, Ponder's interesting. I think I'll wait on the Ponder. I'm actually fine to go Mystic Sanctuary back Swords to Plowshares here. And then just chill for another turn with Snap Counterspell. Since that's such an expensive play, it's really good to land, and it's really unlikely that they port me first. Sanctum Prelate, yeah, that is what I would call an unacceptable card, because they're going to name one and shut off my Swords and my Ponder. No good. No good at all. Counterspell you. And then now, you know, I'm not going to get max Yorion value, but I can live with that. Because I'm going to play Yorion this turn for sure. Question is, do I want to Ponder first? I guess so. I guess it's fine to do a little pondering. I'll keep Brainstorm on top. I'll crack Tarn. I'm going to have to get Trop now. Oh, I guess the Astrolabe's actually working right now. Thanks to the Revoker being gone, but I mean, might as well exile the Snappy. Why not? No harm, no foul. If I had more mana, I could have really gone off there. But I mean, this is already pretty good. Like, I have the Swords up, or rather Force up. I have a Brainstorm to shuffle away this Oko. I have Astrolabe, so my mana's fine. And I have a 4/5 flyer. What are you going to do about that? I'll probably counter a Stoneforge Mystic here if they play that. Council's Judgment. Oh, I definitely counter on that. I'll pitch the Oko here. I don't want my Yorion to be gone. That doesn't sound fun. Wasteland me. Go nuts. They have something else too? Okay, Wasteland my Trop. Sure. Draw for turn. Oh yeah, counterspell is really nice. Might as well brainstorm now. Put back island and a force of will. And then I'm going to ponder and shuffle unless I hit something awesome. Oh, they're just done. Sweet. And we're 2-0 with Legacy Yorion. Let's get into another match. Alrighty, time for round three. I would, in fact, like to play first and reveal Yorion Sky Nomad to my opponent. Let's see. Have they come to the battle? Luris. Oh, Gyruda, the Doom. Depth. Doom of Depths. Awesome. Well, you love to see it. I'm going to keep this hand because I think Force of Negation is decent against them. Need to counter like a Lion's Eye Diamond or something. So what they're looking to do here is use a couple Lion's Eye Diamonds and just to slam a Gyruda there and, I don't know, mill a bunch of clones and or Gristlebrands or Dragonlord Kolaghan to give them all haste, that sort of stuff. Ooh, Cavern of Souls. That's going to be a pretty tough one for me. They're going to name Kraken, Demon, one of the two. And there's a Lion's Eye Diamond. There's a Chromox. Wow, should I have countered the first Lion's Eye Diamond? I probably should have. I was like, well, I'll just counter the second one. Do they have a turn one? Oh, Grim Monolith. I guess I can just counter that. It's kind of the same either way. Well, yikes. This is going to be hard, though. They're going to be able to play Gyruda on turn two. I guess, you know what? Maybe I should hold on to this Brainstorm so that I can set up a Terminus. Yeah, I think I'll do that, actually. I mean, I might just die here, but if I wait and then they don't kill me in one shot, that's a potential solution. Okay. I guess I can brainstorm in response, because if I find another Force of Will, I will probably force. All right. I didn't put Mystic Sanctuary and Terminus back. Oh, that doesn't even work. Right. Oh, they didn't go for Gyruda. Well, in that case, I'll just shuffle. Because they even actually make it so that I mill my top four, so I needed to not do that in response. I have not played against a ye old Gyruda before. They did not end up tossing it out. Interesting. All right, well, I guess I'll just pass now and see how things turn out. I'm curious why they didn't play it. I wonder if their hand was good enough that they thought. Because remember, they can sack Lion's Eye Diamond at any point. Oh, they're going to play one from their hand first. Okay. Do your thing, I guess. And mills for four. And didn't hit anything. Ha! Taste it. They even build my Savine's Reclamation, which I don't know, they have good targets now, but that's not bad. All right, let's crack this Misty for another island here. And play Ice Fang Quaddle. Seems pretty decent. And draw, and then I can play Jace, I can play Narset. I think I'm in just to play Jace and just brainstorm here. Let's put back Veil of Summer and I guess another Astrolabe because the second one's a lot less important. And pass. I feel like there's a good chance I'll get milled this turn when they play Gyruda from their hand. Or they have like a clone of, this is like a spark double. Unfortunate part is I don't have a counterspell for spark double. There's no way they're going to miss again. They missed again. Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. That is awesome. And they're not going to mill me out. I have Yorion. I have way too many cards to get milled out. They didn't attack. Interesting. I guess they didn't want to trade, and then I bounced their thing with Jace. Sure, that makes sense to me. They're like kind of close. I could bounce. Let's see. I think I'm going to hit them first. Yeah, let's hit them with Ice Fang. And then I'm going to play Yorion and flicker all my stuff. And then I don't really want to bounce either. I could bounce their original because they already have an OG to cast, but I'm just going to have to deal with it eventually, so that doesn't seem great to me. I'll get a Tundra now, I guess. And I guess we just cast Yorion here. Though the question is if I want to bounce with Jace first, because then I can reset Jace back to 3. That doesn't matter too much. I definitely don't want to bounce Bark Double. But if I bounce Druda here... No, that just doesn't seem good. Let's just play Yorion and then probably end up brainstorming with Jace here. I guess I could brainstorm first because I'm not drawing the cards right away. Whatever. Exile those two. And draw 3. I could use a Force of Will at some point. I would not mind that. But Astral Aven, a Ponder back. I guess it doesn't matter what I put back because I'm going to draw them right away. Okay, so... I have a Force of Negation, which unfortunately doesn't do a whole lot against their deck. And if they run out of things to cast from hand, they can sack the LED to cast Geruda here. And at some point, they're going to hit with this. Yep, Phantasmal Image. So now at least they don't get to keep both. All right, they hit Thassa's Oracle and Dax Duplicate. Yeah, now they're going off. Because now they get to hit copy again with Dax Duplicate. And then they hit another Dax Duplicate and a Spark Double. Yeah. I think missing twice... There's a Metamorph. I think missing twice was about as much as I could ask for. But this matchup seems particularly bad. Oh, Dread Return. That's a cool card. And Sakashima the Imposter. Nice. Okay, now I don't think they can miss here. Progenitor Mimic. Oh yeah, there we go. I wonder how many of these can actually stay in play at the end of all this. I guess like a decent amount of them, right? I guess we'll find out. I mean, I don't care if they look at all the cards in my deck here. And then now they can still get back. They can get back Thassa's Oracle, Dread Return, or Geruda, whatever, and that'll be enough. Well, I like From the Ashes because it can kill Cavern of Souls, which is going to be a pretty important card. And then Surgical could be a thing. Oh, Containment Priest is nice. Okay, so this does get quite a bit better post-board here. I'll even put in Wilt. I'm going to take out the Wrath. I don't think Wrath is actually going to do it. I guess Entreat actually is a way to be faster, so that's probably good. I'll take out Veil of Summers. And... I need to take out some more cards still. Source to Plash is also... I think that removal itself just doesn't seem that good. Oh, actually, that's not true. Hold on. Swords is different. If they play Geruda, I can Swords it in response. Is that good, though? I mean, I think I'd rather just have random blue cards in my deck, actually. That doesn't seem that good. Savine's Reclamation is a bit rough, but I guess... No, this just doesn't seem good. Because the thing is, none of the Planeswalkers actually stop them from doing their thing. And I'll probably take out one of the Okos as well. And then I guess my goal is to just counter all their things as long as they don't have Cavern of Souls. That's my plan. All right, well, we'll see. This does seem like a hard matchup because they're a fast combo deck. Oh, Containment Priest seems very good, though. A fast combo deck that, you know, I'm not able to pressure them. And I think that's a little rough. So I guess I'm going to sequence my lands such that I just get Island and then Plains. And then I can get green later, maybe. I don't know. I hope they don't have a turn. Last game they had a turn 2 Geruda. But hopefully they don't have that on turn 1 here. Let's find out. They probably have the Cavern of Souls too. Chromox, okay. I mean, hopefully this is a turn 1 Grim Monolith and not a turn 1. Oh geez, this could easily be a turn 1. Okay. Do you have a Lion's Eye Diamond? No, you don't. Alright, let's just wait on the duel. There's no real reason to crack it yet. Ha! How nice of you to show up, Astrolabe. pass the turn. And we'll find out if they go for it or not. If they've got the cavern, they're definitely going to go for it. Well, that's fine. It would have been nicer if they went for it with Lion's Eye Diamond at some point here, but let's see. Hopefully they're casting the one from their hand, their companion zone. All right, so let's get a Snow Island and a Snow Plains here. Let's cast Containment Priest. I mean, they have a 6-6 now, which I guess I've got Okos and other things to deal with. But, ooh, they milled an AK. Heh, now I can go off. Intuition for the other three. Seems pretty good. Right, and, ha! Caracas. That is also an answer. I'll take my 6 first. I'll wait on this so they don't know it's coming. But, yeah, that's pretty good. Caracas is nice here. What does their deck do against a Containment Priest in play, I guess? Oh, I guess that's the reason to Caracas. Do I want to Intuition? Nah, this is fine. So this is not legendary. So the new copy is... Yeah, it's a 6-6 creature, so I can't actually Caracas that. But... I guess playing Caracas would have been a good idea. They definitely screwed that up. All right, let's, I'm at 12. Yeah, let's just Intuition targeting you. I'm just going to get the AKs. And then on my turn, I'm going to cast AK for a million. Oh, that's interesting. Huh. I don't actually have the ability to play from the ashes, sadly. Let's leave a blue up here. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. All right, let's play Astrolabe. And then I can force... Yeah, there's a lot I can do here. Let's just pass and discard... Let's discard a Force of Will, probably. And then... Let's see. So this I'm going to have to Force of Will. It's going to be another Spark Double. That's okay. We'll Force of Will that, pitching Force of Negation. And then... We can bounce... Geruda here. Oh, do they have counters back? I kind of assume, I guess they have Pact of Negation, maybe? And then... Bounce that... And then they can hit us for 7, but we can Pyroblast that. So the question really is, do I want to cast From the Ashes? I kind of feel like I don't. Let's just brainstorm. Okay, let's put back Intuition and brainstorm for now. Let's play a land and then hit for 2. And then... Our plan now is if they play another clone, I can Pyroblast their Geruda in response here. And then they have to clone my Containment Priest, which I'm fine with. I also have a counterspell up. And they have Geruda in hand, but it's not really doing much for them. Yeah, once their deck is relying on 6/6s to try and win, it's a little tougher for them for sure. Okay. And if they want to metamorph a Containment Priest, Pact, huh? Good for you. Good for you. I'm going to counterspell the Pact. I guess I have to do that. If they have another Pact, that'd be pretty rough. Not going to lie. Maybe I should have left my Containment Priest back. I don't know. I kind of want to kill my opponent here. Or at least do my best to do so. So they're going to make a containment priest? No, they're just going to make a grim monolith. Well, that's fair. Let's just play Oko. I have to use the thing. We'll make a food. Play Mystic Sanctuary to get back accumulated knowledge. And then I guess I'll just pass in case they have some sort of haster or something, like Dax duplicate. I guess I have the food token, so maybe that's, maybe I should have just attacked anyway. I don't know. This is lethal over two turns, and then next turn I can maybe play Yorian as well. But I think that they're in a bit of trouble. We'll see. I don't know what else they've got. Okay, they've got lots of Grim Monoliths. They can do their thing with Grim Monolith. I suppose that's acceptable. They're going to make another Gyruda. But playing the original just doesn't really accomplish much with Caracas in play. Okay, but they're doing it anyway. Unless it's a different Kraken. It'd be funny if it were. Just going to bounce it in response. I don't really know what can go wrong, but I'm not really that worried. All right, they didn't even hit anything. Funny. And they haven't seen From the Ashes yet. Not that that really matters. I don't really know what they could do to in order to use From the, to play around From the Ashes. But, all right. Ha, I drew Entreat. Oh, because I got milled from Druda. Funny. Yeah. I guess I'll cast Entreat, sure. Let's see. White. X. 1, 2, 3. Leave Caracas up. And since this is non-token creature, Entreat still works. And then I get to probably make my food into a creature, attack my opponent for five here. And play my land. And yeah, I see no reason not to attack for five. They go to three. I'm not even sure what they can cast. They have a cavern, a blue-green mox, and an ancient tomb. None of those grims are untapping. So. All right, the combination of Caracas and Containment Priest pretty much shut my opponent down. Pyroblast also fairly strong against them. They can resolve Gyruda and I can just Pyroblast it in response. It's kind of the idea. Though I should probably put in Veil of Summer because they do have Pact of Negation. And that might be better than something like Wilt. I don't even know if I guess Surgical stops Thassa's Oracle, so that's probably good enough. Uro seems a bit rough, though I guess they are milling it, which is kind of nice. I actually don't mind that. I think Narset and Jace might be. I'll just take out the Narset. I think maybe I should have some swords in. No, they're really only good in the spot. I don't know where I guess it. Yeah, I guess I have all the Pyroblasts. I don't know. Maybe it's actually just heinously wrong not to have swords in. I'm not even 100% sure. Well, I'm going to keep my hand with Caracas and Pyroblast. And it doesn't hurt that I've got a Force of Will here either. So I like this hand. Maybe we'll see who the best champion is indeed. They're debating whether or not to keep. They're probably just like wondering how to turn one me here. Also, if they at some point don't draw Cavern of Souls, this matchup gets a lot easier. Cavern is a beating, that's for sure. Put a mulligan. Oh, I'm going to keep this hand. Containment Priest is likely just my best card by a lot, but I don't think I can mull this hand. It's got two pretty cheap answers plus a Force of Will and the right mana to cast my spells. So, the question is, if they lead with the card Lion's Eye Diamond, what do? I think I just let that resolve. Yeah, they've got Cavern. But of course. Hmm. Okay, they have Mox. I'm not Force Walling a Chromox. And then they're going to play Grim Monolith. That I will Force of Will. I think forcing a 3-mana rock is pretty good. Play Prismatic Vista here. Plus, forcing on a turn where they can't use Pact of Negation is kind of nice. Okay, no plays. I'll play Caracas now. And then, next turn, if they don't do anything, I get to Intuition for my last three accumulated knowledges, most likely. But I guess next turn they're probably going to play Garuda here. If I had to guess, play my island, pass the turn. Thing is, with a Caracas in play, it's actually not that bad. I guess they can mill a second Garuda, but here's what'll happen. They'll play Mox Diamond, sure. They'll play Garuda. In response to the trigger, I'm going to bounce it with Caracas. They're going to mill four, and they'll hope to hit another one. But if they just hit a clone, then they're done. Okay, can't be countered, sure. Trigger, in response, bounce. And then if they hit another one, I at least get to Pyroblast. They hit Spark Double. It doesn't do anything. All right, cool. Did they mill any AKs? They did not. I guess I should play my fetches because I'm probably going to have to do some fetching at some point here. I guess I can Mystic Sanctuary like a counterspell or something next turn, but Mystic Sanctuary doesn't really do that much. Okay, I'll just Caracas it again. I don't know. It doesn't seem like I'm really losing out. They're taking two damage and spending their entire turn, multiple turns in a row. I'll let this happen. Okay, they hit a Thassa's Oracle. That's fine. The only thing that would have been annoying is if they milled an AK, but even then, that's not too bad of a play here. Let's go ahead. I guess I should have cracked. Maybe I should have actually done it earlier to crack the Vista in case they got all my mountains. I think I'll just get Island here. I could get Forest, but I'm not really casting any green cards right now. I like Caracas enough. Oh, I can't even get From the Ashes. I guess I have a Snapcaster, so I can kind of get everything. Let's just get AKs. Because with a Snapcaster and a Mystic Sanctuary in hand, it feels like getting a bunch of 1-2 mana draw threes into my deck is pretty nice. Oh, interesting. Surgical Extraction, huh? What do I have to cast? I guess I have things to cast. Let's just play this and pass. I don't want to AK now because there's a chance I might need to use multiple cards next turn, but I feel pretty good about the situation. Even just a straight up Caracas is kind of winning me this game. It's wild. So they're going to play Garuda. So now, now it's kind of interesting. How much do I care about them cloning Thassa's Oracle, I guess, is the question. Because I think I might want to just kill Thassa's Oracle. I think that that's going to be better rather than cloning. Okay, they didn't hit anything. Good. I was a little worried they'd hit another Garuda, but if they did, I guess at some point I could surgical, snapcaster, surgical. I don't know. All right, let's AK for three here. Brainstorm from the Ashes. I'm just worried about From the Ashes because though I don't think they have any basics in their deck. This Caracas is doing good, but I guess, you know what? I think it might actually be time to play From the Ashes. Oh, and then I drew a Containment Priest. Okay, so let's put back Euro. I think that's the one I want the least. Draw. Let's see. And this isn't tapped. So let's go from the ashes. And then blows up their three lands. I guess they can pack this. Okay, yeah, I'll use the ability. So let's get Plains Island. And see if they have any Plains in their deck, or basics in their deck. They might have like one. No, they don't even have any. Okay, let's play Containment Priest. Just play this now. So they can't pact or do any other counters. And I think that's it. Yorian Reign Supreme. Really, Caracas Reign Supreme. That was the best card. And, let's get to our next match. Alrighty. Time for round four. I would like to play first, and I would like to announce that Yorian will be accompanying me here. Oh, yeah. I don't think you're allowed to mulligan a hand in Legacy with the cards Snow-Covered Island and Arkham's Astrolabe. Ooh, Zerta the Dawnwaker. I'm playing against another artifact-based companion deck. Funny. Okay. Hopefully I don't draw land off this. Oh, Brainstorm. Perfect. I just do Ancestral Recall. No big deal. So my opponent's deck is likely going to have a bunch of stuff like Grim Monolith and Basalt Monolith, I think, to try to go off with this thing. But, I mean, who knows? Let's brainstorm first here. And I'm going to put back Terminus and land. And play a land and pass. And then I'll start casting AKs here soon enough. And I'll certainly be shuffling here. I will not... Not interested in redrawing that. Yeah, you can brainstorm. They're gonna crack their Misty, yeah. At some point, they're gonna want. I guess they have an Astrolabe. Yeah, they're gonna want white mana for that Zerta, I would assume. Ponder. Alright, so they're looking for their combo pieces. Swords to Plowshares does break up the combo because they do need to have Zerta in play in order to run this. Let's just crack this and get another island here. Could use some counter spells. Veil of Summer. Oh yeah, Force of Negation is nice. At this point, I don't have a strong need to shuffle, and I have the mana I need from Astrolabe to cast Swords, so let's just play Trop and pass. Of course, I'm not really worried about Wasteland out of the deck I'm facing. If they play Zerta, I guess we just allow it. Ooh, what are they playing off? This Oko? Oh, Kinan Bonder Prodigy. Okay. So, this makes it so their Astrolabe now tap for mana. Okay. Not countering your Astrolabe. I'm probably going to try to kill that Kinan end of turn here. All right. And then I'll cast AK. Ooh, into more AKs. Oh, can't entreat, unfortunately. Let's just play a Strand and pass. And now I have the play, if I want, of crack Strand to get Mystic Sanctuary to put Swords to Plowshares back on top, then cast Cumulative Knowledge, and then cast Swords to Plowshares. But I don't know that I'm going to want to use that. And I have another fetch in hand, so I don't have to do it this turn. But it seems like it could be good. I guess I'm just playing two Mystic Sanctuaries. Basalt Monolith. So I think I just force that. Just hard cast force while I have the opportunity to do so. All right. And then now I'm going to get Mystic Sanctuary. And I'm going to get back Swords to Plowshares. And then I'm going to play my land and pass the turn. And I kind of want to use this Misty as well to get a Mystic Sanctuary. But what I want to do is cast AK, then cast another AK. So hopefully this turn I don't have to do something else. Their deck seems cool. The combination of Zerta and Kinan to get a bunch of value here. Oko, Thief of Crowns. Yeah, I mean, that's an annoying card. Let's AK here. And then let's AK here. Okay, Oko's fine then. I really don't care that much about Oko. I mean, I guess eventually Oko gets annoying, but... All right, let's crack this. It's getting under Mystic Sanctuary. I think I just put back AK. Seems fine to me. And then, do I want to brainstorm here? Kind of don't want to do that yet. Let's draw... Cast AK. Because I want to maximize the ability for Euro to play two lands. Are they going to force me here? All right. I actually don't really care too much about that. So I guess it's probably better to brainstorm now than maybe I should have done that in response, but I don't know. We'll brainstorm now. Put back two copies of Terminus. Play a land. Crack this, and I guess... At this point, I'd probably just get Trop. And actually just pass the turn, I think. Maybe I didn't need to crack that main phase, but I don't really want to... I don't really want to be tapped out here. What did they pitch to force? Hold on. Wait, where's their exiled zone? Oh, I see. They pitched another Kinna and Bonder Prodigy, sure. Brainstorm into Misty. I guess I do need to start dealing with this Oko somehow. Uro's actually solid. They can turn Uro into an elk, but then Uro trades off and just comes back. So that's not too bad. Yeah. I think if they send in a food token at me, I'm just going to trade a Quaddle for it. That seems fine. Since I'm not doing anything else with this. I have three snow permanents thanks to Astrolabe. Ooh, Veil of Summer. That's probably gonna be nice at some point here. Do I want to brainstorm? I guess I have this entreat going on here. Let's just wait on that. Okay. Just play Jace. If they have another counter spell, I've got this Veil of Summer. Very much ready to go. And then, oh, do they have the actual card counterspell? Huh. Oh, no, they have more brainstorms, sure. The question is, I'm probably going to plus Jace now. Do I plus Jace on them? I hope they have Force of Will. Oh. Is there really any better feeling than them casting Force of Will and you casting Veil of Summer? It's just absurd. I'll plus Jace on them. Maybe I'm being a sucker here. Oh yeah, I'll put Urza on the bottom. Or maybe not. Who's the sucker now? I just didn't want to let Jace die to Oko, and I didn't really want to use Swords to Plowshares on the Oko elk token. So this works out quite nicely. And then what I'm probably going to do is brainstorm end of turn and then cast an entreat here next turn. I get to hit Jace down to two. It's fine. I just want to leave Swords up in case they play Zerda into a combo of sorts. Oh no, do they have another Urza? Yeah, that's unfortunate. I'm going to Swords Urza in response. Okay, and then a turn, I'm going to brainstorm. Put back Euro and then entreat. Untap. I'm going to reveal entreat. Yes. Yes, I'll cast it. So, white. One, two, three. I think three is probably good. And then I leave up counterspell. I guess I could leave up four and try to hit a land, but that seems greedy. Just do three here. Draw, play my land. And then I'm going to minus Jace on their construct, I think. And then now they can't Oko my angels. I still have a counterspell up. I feel like I'm in pretty good shape. Yeah, they can Swords me. I guess I F6, but I also don't care if If they Swords the Angel, I wasn't going to counter that. What you got? If they have... Oh, now they have no cards in hand. Yeah, if they play Zerda, I'm just 100% counterspelling it. That's just not even a choice. They have no cards in hand. Not that even does anything right now, but now if I use my counterspell when they have no cards, then I have another counterspell for next turn. Now, Oko's good and all, but I don't... Oko's not actually beating and treat the angels. Yeah, they're elking one of my angels, I guess. So now... Drawing a Euro here. I have Yorion, so why don't I go... They're at 18. Let's just attack Oko here. Trade tokens. Oko goes to 5. I get to brainstorm with Jace here. Put him back Euro and... Euro, and then play... Oh yeah, this is great. I get to play Ice Fang into Yorion here. And then I get to play my companion. Whew. And then Yorion's going to draw me 2 cards and put 2 loyalty on Jace. Yeah, that works for me. Sadly, it comes back end of turn, so I don't get to Jace twice, but I think they figured that out. All right, so now, and now I have Counterspell plus 4, so they have no cards in hand. Oko is good and all, but, I mean, this is Legacy. We're doing powerful things. We're coming in big. Oko by himself, as good as he is not good enough to just defeat my entire deck. Okay, they elked my Angel. Ooh, and they drew Caracas for my Yorion. They can bounce my Moldrifter over and over again if that's what they want to do. let's draw 3. Put back those. And let's attack Oko down to 2, I guess, is the plan. I assume they're going to bounce Yorion. Oh, no, they're just going to let Oko die. That's fine, too. And you play Euro here. Yeah, okay, they're done. I have gotten too much value. Okay, so I don't want the Ruin from the Ashes, but I definitely do want the Pyroblasts and Red Blasts. Those seem good. This doesn't seem to do much. Terminus doesn't seem to do much. And what else do I not want here? I guess Wilt is probably fine. It has cycling. And I mean, Ice Fangs are just okay, but they are actually decent at like keeping Oko kind of in check at like a fairly low cost, and the combo with Yorion is pretty strong. I guess I could take out a land. I am on the draw here. I'm gonna take a snow-covered island out, and then I need to cut 2 more cards. I could cut Savine's Reclamation. I just feel like if I'm playing against a combo deck, I'm less likely to want to get that value from Savine's Reclamation. And I guess the last card I could take out Uro, Titan of Nature's Wrath. Just kind of a slow main phase card. I don't know that I want to tap out for it, you know? All right. Let's see what game 2 has to offer here. There you go. Magic Online. It was taking its sweet time, but we got there. Okay. I'm in for this. Kind of interesting. What do I want to play on turn 1? Kind of a tough decision. I guess, like, this is... If I draw a land... Retrofitter Foundry? Huh, cute. Okay, well, if I draw a land, that's a little easier, because then I just play one of my non-Mystic Sanctuary lands. If I didn't draw a land, then I would want to play Mystic Sanctuary on turn 1. But now that I know this can come into play untapped later, it's fine. No need to sack. No need to do anything, really. Feeling pretty good about my hand now. If I have to cast Counterspell... Oh, that makes a 1-1. Sure, I don't really care about them making a 1-1. And they can pay 1, tap it, and sack and make a flyer. If I have to cast Counterspell, I'm probably getting Basic Island and like a Tundra or something. Basalt Monolith. I guess I should probably counterspell that. I don't know, just getting to use Counterspell here is like fairly strong. And I have swords for Zerda, so that's not too bad. I can also play Oko at some point here. But I kind of think I just get Trop and then kill the Retrofitter Foundry. Or, you know what? I don't care about that. I'm just going to pass. I'm just going to pass and play an Ice Fang. Or potentially Wilt, I guess. I could do either of those things. I just don't see Retrofitter Foundry being that much of a problem. Ponder's good. I suppose I could have also just let Basalt Monolith resolve and end of turn wilted it. And then they would have been able to... They have like Dead of Winter in their deck? I don't know. All right. That's it? All right, I'll play my Ice Fang. If they want to counter my Ice Fang, they can do that. Draw. I'm going to play Oko, I think. They have a lot of cards in hand. Let's just chill. Attack. So what can they do? They can make another Servo. Yeah, actually, I will play Oko here. If it gets countered, which it kind of feels like it's going to, I can accept that. Oh, they forced it? Pitching Urza? Sure. I consider that a successful turn. Whatever it is they're doing with that foundry over there is really not bugging me. All right, now they sack that to make a Thopter. Now I can sack the Thopter to make a 4-4. I see. Karn, the Great Creator. Okay. I don't have a counterspell for that. What are they going to pick up with their Karn here? I got a liquid metal coating. Well, I don't really like that happening. Their Karn's at 3. There's a lot of things I could do here. What do I want to do, though? I could play Yorion next turn. I could get another Mystic Sanctuary, put Counterspell back. I do have that Wilt, though. The Liquid Metal Coating might cost me a land. You know what? I kind of want to just play Yorion, so I'm not gonna bother. I'm going to do another Mystic Sanctuary. That's kind of annoying, actually. Do I attack with the Quaddle into Karn? I guess I'm actually okay trading here. It seems fine. And if they block and sack, that's also fine with me. Okay, that's kind of what I thought they'd do. Alright, and then now I play Yorion. So I'm going to crack Misty because I don't want to put... I don't want to put Counterspell back on top. I'd rather draw Force of Will here. I don't love the position I'm in, but I just don't feel like I can just sit here and do nothing. Okay. Also, if they kill one of my lands, I can deal with that. Like, Yorion can come go kill Karn. Yes, they can also go, potentially, Basalt Monolith plus Zerda kill me. But... the fact that I didn't have a way to stop Karn when it came down, it didn't die to Swords or Wilt, which maybe is a reason that I should have used Wilt on Basalt Monolith instead of Counterspell. Kind of forced my hand. All five colors. Wow. They're doing the thing. Oh, they did have the Basalt Monolith. Yeah, so I am dead. Because they get to play Zerda. Untap. And then they can use Karn to get Walking Ballista. I'm sure they have it. All right. I think the biggest decision point there was the Wilt versus Counterspell decision. For sure. I think I like how I sided, though. So I'm ready to get back in there. Alrighty. Welcome to game 3. Battling against all other companions. All right. We'll reveal Yorion. And all right, this hand works. Not the best hand in the world, but certainly a keepable one. I get to go turn one, ponder, and I guess kind of look for Astrolabe or Counterspell or whatever. My opponent will get into six here. All right, let's go ponder. Force Negation, Ice Fang, Quaddle, Misty Rainforest. Okay, I do like these things. I actually think that Force of Negation is the worst of them there, because I have a Wilt and a Swords. And I'd rather just get that Ice Fang into play here. I mean, I guess I could wait on it. I don't know. Volk into some sort of cantrip. Yeah. I could just play Misty and pass. And then I would draw the Force of Negation. So let's just play Misty and pass and see what's up. There's a chance that I'm fine just drawing Force of Negation. And then there's a chance that I'm not. Well, I'm probably not going to have to cast a Wilt at this point, given that they're pondering. But let's see. They shuffled. And then they have a Retrofitter Foundry. Sure. Yeah, at that point, how annoying is this? I guess they can pay three and make a Servo. This is just so slow. I'm just going to crack this. I'm going to go get my Tropical Island. I'm going to cast Quaddle. And I'm just going to try to draw some more lands to make it so Euro gets to put some extra... I drew the Force Negation anyway. Classic. Classic. All right. Titan of Nature's Wrath here. And the question is, if I don't draw a land, I guess that answers that question. I was going to say, do I put the Mystic Sanctuary into play? And the answer is no. Okay. So I'm like not too far away from being able to bring Euro back if I can start casting some spells over the next couple turns here. Seems like their hand has been like a little bit awkward, but who knows. Also, these decks look so much worse when they don't draw Astrolabe. Both of our decks, to be honest. Like, I'm sure my opponent's hand is just a bunch of Kinan Bonder Prodigies and stuff. Oh, there's the Astrolabe. How lucky. Oh, Relic of Progenitus. Okay, sure. That's fine. And I guess I'll just wait on this Flooded Strand. Oko, Thief of Crowns. So what I'm going to do is crack this for actually a Volk. Well, huh. This is not obvious to me. So I'm going to get a Volk or a Trop because I want to play Mystic Sanctuary. I want to play Yori on this turn. The question is, do I want to get a red? I think it's just worth more to get a red here. And then I'm going to try to put Ponder back on top. If they let me do it, I'll put the Ponder back on top. Okay. And then I'm going to hit my opponent for one. They can't make a flying blocker. And I'm going to play Yorion here. And then if this works out, hopefully they don't have Force of Will. If they do, they do, and I can't stop that. I'll have to use Oko. If they don't, though, it's seeming like they do. Yeah, Force, Pitching Force. All right. I was going to say I could use Yorion, draw a card, and then next turn use Force plus, and then untap and get Swords and, you know, hit them to death with Yorion and Ice Fang. But instead this. All right. Well, now I can play Oko at least. That doesn't seem too bad. So let's play Oko, Thief of Crowns, leaving up Force of Negation, Swords. I'll just make a food token. If they Pyroblast Oko, I guess I'll live with that. So right now they can pay two and tap and make a Servo. And then that's it. That's all they can do right now. So I can attack. And then at some point they'll make something and I'll Swords it and reset them or whatever. And I'm not playing Ponder because I want to leave up Force of Negation. No reason not to, I don't think. Like, I'm not in a hurry to find something here. I don't really want to cycle this Wilt either. Okay, so they're going to make their 1-1, sure. I'll allow that. Also, if I really want to, I can just Oko the Retrofitter Foundry. Retrofit this. Bam. I'll whack Oko for 1. Oko can take some hits, I'll tell you that. Okay, so now they have... If they have Basalt Monolith, I'll let that resolve. Because I have Swords for Azurda. And I also have Wilt. I also have Oko if I need to. Urza, I guess I'll have to let resolve. Kinan, Bond, or Prodigy. Certainly. Well, I can't counter that. I kind of want to counter Astrolabe, but they already have 5 colors of mana. It just can't be worth it. Pyroblast Oko, huh? Alright. I have a decent amount of threats in the deck. I think I'm just going to let that happen. Because pitching a Ponder is also a pretty big cost. Oh, that's not a bad one. Let's Ponder. Brainstorm, Force of Will, Misty Rainforest. Interesting. Yeah, that seems okay. I'll keep the Brainstorm. I'm going to hit them. If they want to make a Thopter to trade, they can. And what I'm probably going to do here, given that I'm not doing anything right now, I feel like I should probably Wilt the Retrofitter Foundry. So now they make a 1-1. Yeah, let's just do that. Again, I might run into problems here if I have to like counter something on their turn. But I've got Force, Pitch, and Brainstorm if I need to. My top card's Force of Will. Urza would be the most annoying. Yeah, Basalt Monolith is fine, I think. I guess it actually kind of isn't fine. Because now they only need to spend 1 mana to untap it. But I guess if they had an extra mana, it'd be a lot worse for me. I guess I'll sword Zurda now. Huh. I wonder if maybe... I mean, this worked out better for me, but I wonder if that was actually just not a good idea. That might have just been a little bit greedy. I don't really like... this. So the question is, yeah, I'll just force this. I don't really feel like I'm clocking them enough to justify not countering the foundry here. I have Force of Will. Yeah, sure. I don't have a Yorian anymore, so I'm fine trading now. And now I have Hardcast Force plus Swords and Veil of Summer if I need to. Okay, what do they have? Karn. No, that I will counter. Now, I'm running a little thin. I'm drawing Misty Rainforest here, which can get Mystic Sanctuary. I guess I can get back Ponder if they don't do anything. Seems okay. It's not great. Kinan, Bonder, Prodigy, okay. So I'm gonna crack this, sure. Okay, so now they can Astrolabe here. And what are they gonna do with that? And now the question too is, do I wanna cycle Veil of Summer? It might be decent. It'd give me a little more information on what I wanna use the Misty Rainforest to do. Double blue. Do they have like a Urza or something? Yikes. Okay, let's cycle Veil of Summer. They have no cards in hand, so I'm not... Oh, okay. Interesting. Snapcaster. So, I can't... I guess I can't do everything. But I can Swords Urza, and then that leaves them pretty close to being able to use Kanan. So let's go Swords Urza. And then I can snap. I guess snap swords. Do I want a Mystic Sanctuary first? I don't even know if that's good, to be honest. I mean, I could Mystic Sanctuary get a Ponder. I kind of just want to wait and see what I draw. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to kill the Bonder Prodigy and hope they don't draw something this turn here, because otherwise I think that's just gonna be too much value. Okay, I'm at 21. They're at 17. They have a 3/3 that can grow. They have the first crack at things, but I have a Force of Will in hand. So if they didn't draw anything this turn, do I want to get back anything? I don't know that cracking is better than drawing a Ponder. Well, I guess that removes that option, doesn't it? Well, so look, here's the good thing, is I can play this, get back my Ponder, and now because I have a Misty Rainforest, I can actually have access to Ponder plus Shuffle, which is quite a bit more powerful. They can untap their Basalt Monolith here, but that's fine. I mean, I don't want them to draw gas. I guess I'd rather them just draw like all nonsense. But now would be a decent time for them to draw gas because I could hard cast Force of Will. Okay, so I'm going to draw Ponder here. I think they just have a land in hand. Or like a Force of Will of their own. Who knows? Ooh, I like all of this. What do I want first? It's almost assured they got to be snap first. Okay, and then I get to send. And Swords second, because they have a lot of good Swords targets in their deck. And Pyroblast third. And if they don't do anything here, do I want to go like end of turn snap Wilt? I kind of feel like I do. Because I'm not going to be able to back up Snapcaster with Force of Will no matter what. Just too expensive. We're like not quite there yet. Kind of feel like snap Wilt will be decent. If they have Swords or Pyroblast, so be it. Feels like they might. Ooh, all right. Let's get Wilt. I'm reaching the end of my graveyard effects. I've already got both my Mystic Sanctuaries here, and I've got Anjorian's Gun. I can't blink my Snapcasters. I guess I can bounce them with Teferi or Jace, but using the Wilt out of the graveyard is not a big deal. And now they're on a fairly fast clock. My top card's a Pyroblast 2, which I kind of feel like I should just keep. Pyroblast has to be better than a random card at this point in the game because it can counter Urza, it can counter Kanan. All right, well, I'm going to definitely counter Retrofitter Foundry. If they have a Force, that's kind of problematic. They do. Okay, well now I guess I can't draw Pyroblast. So I got to shuffle. Retrofitter Foundry. I guess it did not work out well to draw Swords before Pyroblast, did it? Let's get a Trop here. All right. Action. Oko. Force Will is not horrendous. It's not going to be good enough probably right now because I'm not going to be able to kill them through Retrofitter Foundry with just the Snapcasters. Because right now they have 3/6 mana. They can go... I guess they're not at a point where they're making 2 a turn, but they can still just make 1 a turn and trade. I could have Swords there, but that only does 1 extra damage to them. I don't think that really gets me where I want it to be. I don't care about Relic. I need to draw Oko, is what I need to draw. Though Teferi would also be pretty good. I probably shouldn't trade because of Teferi. Though, I guess the Relic of Progenitus is going to make this a little worse anyway. Okay, so they get to make 1 token end of turn. Man, if I'd switched Pyroblast and Swords, I would be very much in the lead here. And now I'm behind. I'm not incredibly behind in the sense that I have some pretty strong cards that if I just draw, though, I kind of wish my Savine's Reclamation wasn't in the sideboard the way this game's turned out. But if I just draw an Oko or a Jace or even a Teferi Time Raveler, I think that would go a pretty long way here. Oh, another one? No. That I cannot be okay with. I guess I didn't need to tap my planes, but kind of assumed I'm not casting swords this turn anyway. Okay. Yeah, I'll take it. I just don't want to lose Snapcaster. Though if I draw Time Raveler, I don't even know if I'm bouncing Snapcaster. I could crack that food at some point as well. Oh no. I'm flooding out. Yikes. So now they get to make a Thopter, or make a Servo. Oh, they're sacking this to make a Thopter. And they're going to untap it. And they're going to sack it to make a Construct. Okay. I guess that's fine. I guess I have to Swords that, don't I? So now they can make a Servo, untap it. They're still not even where they can make two Servos a turn. They can make a Servo, untap it, and make a Thopter, I guess. I don't know. I just need to draw something here. It begins with one AK. Oh. I kind of wish they didn't come that way, but I guess I can make two angels now. That's probably good. Wait, do I have enough Tundras in my deck? Yeah, I do. Yeah, I guess it's better than waiting a turn, I think. Wow, kind of brutal that I drew the AK first instead of just drawing Entreat. I could have made so many angels. Imagine if I just drawn Entreat, I would have made six angels. That's funny. Funny. Let's just chill. Could attack with Snap, but it doesn't really even matter because they can just make a Servo, make a Thopter, untap it, make a Thopter. So they're making like a 4-4 every like turn, and like every two turns they get a 4-4 and like a 1-1 or something. Funny. Well, if they don't draw anything here. If they don't draw anything here, I'm going to kill them with these angels faster than they can kill me. Oh, no. Oko's going to be tough. Because they can make one of my angels into a 3-3, and then I can't even attack with that angel into the 4-4. All right. Need to draw some action here. An Oko of my own? Like, attacking with this angel doesn't even do anything. They can just block with the Thopter and make it into a 4-4. I guess I could attack with both, but then they just sack Thopter into 4-4 and block that angel instead. And if I, and they can even just make another Construct, too. Yep. This is unfortunate. I wanted to go undefeated, but it does not look like that is going to be the case here. And, you know, I think that this match has been pretty sweet. Like, I think part of what's sweet now. Okay, now I'm super dead here. The Urza's just going to kill me. I just don't have anything going on. I haven't done much in the last bunch of turns. But the companions, I think, actually did make this match better. I think the Garuda match is kind of dumb just because Garuda's, like, doesn't. All right, we're done here. Garuda doesn't really go anywhere but exactly where it went. But yeah, Yorion was really fun to play over this league. And, I ended up going 3-2 in the league. I played the first match just as a warm-up. And so I ended up going 3-1 in the video. Would have been nice to 4-0, but what can you do? And then playing against Zerda, like, their deck was cool. I don't know. Yes, I think Lurrus is kind of dumb, and I'm not a big fan. But I think Yorion's pretty fun, and I was glad that we got to have this experience. Thanks for watching, and of course, remember to sign up for CFP Pro. You'll get the kind of first crack at a lot of awesome strategy, deck guides, reviews, draft guides, everything you want. So go to channelfireball.com/pro, and it's a good deal. $10 a month, $10 store credit, or just $5 a month. So either way, I think we've got a pretty good deal for you, and I'd highly encourage you to join. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.